Now that we know how to create and analyze a one-variable data table, let's look at a two-variable data table to see what it can do for us. What if we just discovered that the sales price for the product that we've been analyzing in the two previous videos, the TZ Swim Skin, depends upon its cost to manufacture it? Also, the purchasing department still hasn't gotten around to calculating our cost per unit. In other words, the cost of goods sold could vary on us some still. Let's set up a worksheet that calculates the probability for all the possible combinations of selling price in C9 and the cost of goods sold in C11. If we were to vary the cost of goods sold, since we don't know that exact figure yet, and the selling price, what will the effects be on the marginal pre-tax income for all of the possible combinations of these two values? To begin with, now let's go ahead and set up the structure of the two-variable data table. A two-variable data table will, go figure, handle two different variables simultaneously, just like the one-variable data table had its input values in certain increments along the left-hand column. Our two-variable data table will have that same column, as well as having another possible set of values perpendicular to that column along the top row of what will end up being our data table. To set up that structure, let's set up the first variable and its increments. The first variable that we're going to set up is the cost of goods sold per unit. We've been told that this cost per unit could end up being anywhere between $49.75 and $109.75 and could change in $5 increments. With that, we could see how that will affect our marginal pre-tax income as our cost of goods sold changes up or down. Our next variable that needs to be up here at the top of our table, in the top row perpendicular to our cost of goods sold pricing, will be our selling price. The selling price, we said, could change between $99.95 and $149.95 in $10 increments. This is the overall structure now of our two-variable data table. One variable changing in this column, and the other varying across this top row. As we may or may not remember from our first video of Lesson 8, a one-variable data table allows us to calculate many outputs as our one single input varies, while the two-variable data table allows us to calculate one solitary output for every combination of two different inputs. At the intersection of the row and the column is where we put that one output formula, and in this example, we're most concerned with how the changing of these two different variables affects the bottom line of our analysis, or in this case, our marginal pre-tax income. So in that cell, we type in equals and then click on cell H20 that holds that magic value. This setup will end up having the data table find this pre-tax income for every combination of cost and selling price in this table. To complete our data table, like we did with our one variable data table, we click on the upper left corner of our cell range and then drag down to the lower right-hand corner down here. We next go up to the data ribbon and select What If Analysis and then Data Table. We see this familiar dialog box pop up with input cells for our row input and column input cells. In our previous example, we just put our column information in for our one variable data table, but since we now have two variables, we get to fill out both of these cells. For our column input cell, each of these values needs to be able to take the place of our cost of goods sold, so I click on that cell, C11. Now, additionally, we get to say that the values in this top row gets to be substituted into our selling price cell, or C9. We're now good to go, so I hit OK, and we have all the marginal pre-tax income values calculated here in our table for every possible combination. How cool is that? To make this table a bit easier to visualize, let's add some formatting to it. First, I'll add some borders, then I'll make this top row and left column bold and currency. I'll come up here and add in the sales prices description. Now I'll highlight all of these cells and make the negative values jump out a bit more for me by being red and in parentheses. I'll also add a title to this table, Income Before Taxes Given. And varying sales prices and cost of goods per unit. And as you may or may not remember back in Chapter 2, this cell here with the marginal pre-tax income, I would rather have it say something like cost of goods per unit as opposed to just this number. So I'm going to go into that. I'll right-click, format, custom. So I'll pick this one and wipe everything out, and I'll type in double quotes, COGS per unit, double quotes, semicolon, and then I'll repeat that again and again, three times. One for positive values, one for negative values, and one for zero values. Now that we've completed our two-variable data table, we need to figure out how to interpret it. Right off the bat, I can easily see that if the sales price is under $100, then we can never make a profit, regardless of our cost of goods sold. Please notice that I said regardless and not irregardless, since there's no such word. Kind of a pet peeve of mine. Kind of like folks saying supposedly or something. That drives me nuts, since it isn't even a word, but alas, I digress. Moving on from my soapbox, if the selling price climbs to $109.95, then it looks like we'll squeak out a small profit if our costs are down here on the very lowest end of the cost of goods range of values. If we are able to sell our 3,000 units at this price out here on the right of $149.95, then we'll make a profit as long as our costs stay below $94.75. In general, as the selling price goes up, we can see that our potential to make a profit increases, and we have a bit more slack in what kind of deal our buyers are able to negotiate with our material suppliers. We can also perform what-if analysis by changing our other input assumptions. For instance, if we were to change our unit sold value from 3,000 down to 2,000, let's see how that affects our data table. As we can see, this drop in sales volume has a pretty drastic effect. You couldn't see our swim skins for anything under $130 and ever expect to make a profit. As we saw before with our one-variable data table, with our new two-variable data table, we can still perform the same sensitivity analysis by changing the different input assumptions and see how drastically they change our output variables. The only big difference here is that we can now only analyze one output calculation at a time. I'll return our unit sold assumption back to 3,000 units. We can now use these different what-if analysis to help us make a more educated decision on whether or not to produce the TZ swim skins, and we can also tell where our volumes, costs, and selling prices need to be in order to make a profit for our company. See you in the next video, where we'll discuss another type of what-if analysis, the dreaded scenario manager.